I'm Christy. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about the chemistry of essential oils. So as I've mentioned all along, I really do believe that essential oils can become another tool in your caregiving toolbox if you choose to use them. Essential oils may be able to increase focus, help prevent or reduce the severity of meltdowns, calm or reduce anxiety, improve sleep, help you recover from sore muscles, and so many more things. There's so many options that you've got with them. The list is nearly endless, and I've seen them used a bunch of different ways and the benefits in my own family. Now, I also realize there are a lot of options out there today, so I'm not going to be recommending any specific company or brand or product in this series. Where you get your oils is up to you, if you decide to use them at all. Now, I should tell you that I do sell for a particular company. If you have no other contacts or need additional support, I would be happy to help you out. You can send me an email at Christy, C-H-R-I-S-T-Y, at havenofhopeforme.com. I also need to say that this series is not intended to provide any medical advice. Please see your medical professional for specific uses for you or for your loved one. This series is purely for informational and educational purposes. The links provided in it are from Google searches I did. I have no contact with, nor am I specifically endorsing any of the companies that I use, with the exception of the one that I sell for, obviously. The information in the linked articles is completely the owner's thoughts and perspectives. So this week, I want to briefly tackle probably the most complicated part of using essential oils, trying to understand their chemical makeup and what makes them so potent and so powerful. Now, let me preface the rest of this by saying, I don't fully understand this myself. It's just too complex for my brain to wrap itself around. But they work wonderfully, powerfully, and that's almost all I need to know. Now, the chemical makeup of an essential oil, as I've said many times, is very complex. There are many different factors that influence the way various chemical components interact with each other. Now, these factors can dramatically change the composition of an oil. Some of these factors include the time of day the plant is harvested, the season, geographic location, method and duration of distillation, the year grown, and the weather. And over on the blog, I have a link to where I got that information. You can find that at www.havenofhopeforme.com. This originally posted in June of 2019. Now, the growth cycle and the processing of the plants impacts their chemical makeup. Okay, that kind of makes sense. Now, essential oils, though, are made up of so many different chemical compounds. Like I quoted in the first video in this series, one of the quotes I had said something like 100 to 200 compounds per essential oil. That's just crazy to me. But this complexity is part of what makes them so powerful and potent, and why one or two drops at a time can easily be sufficient to address an issue. And it's why per dose, essential oils tend to be cheaper than many of the medications in use today. So when I try to understand what they're made of, it quickly becomes confusing and mind-boggling. You hear words like monoterpenes, sesquiterpenes, phenolics, alcohols, esters. Is your mind racing yet? Mine is. So what I did instead, I found five different articles that I linked to on the blog. At least one of them, but I think several of them are a brief overview written in plain English that you can understand, because I understood a fair amount of what they were saying. And so they just explain some of this chemical makeup and how it works. So you can find those over on the blog. Again, that's at www.havenofhopeforme.com. Now, I could go on and bore both of us to death, but this topic, as I've said before, is way over my head. And since I'm not really a science type girl, I don't really care to get into it that much. I'm more than just willing to accept that they just work magically. Now, I know it's not really magic, but it's the chemistry of them, and all the complexity of that chemistry is what makes them so powerful. Okay, I get that. But my chemistry class was a long time ago, and I'm not gonna admit how many years ago it was, but I don't care to go back to it. What I do know is that they're chemically complex and they occur naturally in the world. Okay, I'm good with that. Here's the interesting fact to me. They cannot be reproduced in the lab and have the same results or effects. Now that's a fascinating fact to me. Proves to me that sometimes nothing can beat nature itself. So my question for you this week is this. What is your biggest takeaway from this talk about chemistry and essential oils? Is there anything you'd like to share? I'd love to hear it. You can leave me a comment below, or you can leave me a comment over on the blog. Or if you prefer not to let the whole world know, you can shoot me an email at Christy, C-H-R-I-S-T-Y, at havenofhopeforme.com. As always, I'd appreciate it if you'd share this with anybody you think would find it helpful. I'd love to help as many families as I can. If you haven't already, over on the website, you can sign up for my email list. This will make sure you find out about new content as soon as it's released. On the right side of the website, there's also a place for you to sign up for my course waitlist. The course will be about how to obtain services for your loved one. So signing up will let you know about all course updates as they're released, as well as newly released content. I am so thankful that I don't have to understand all the ins and outs of this chemical stuff to enjoy oils and enjoy their benefits. And using them all the time reminds me that life is good and there is never a dull moment.